Hi and welcome to the essence of set theory. Because the video targets an audience as diverse and broad as I can get, let's first outline what it's all about. Set theory is a mathematical discipline founded in the 19th century by George Cantor. At its core, set theory is the study of infinity, or rather infinite sets to be precise. If you have ever heard some cool stuff about infinity, such as how an infinite number of buses, each with an infinite amount of people, can fit into a single hotel with an infinite number of rooms, or how an infinite number of prisoners wearing colored hats can coordinate their actions such that almost all of them can correctly guess their own hat color, you'll find that these are indeed things strongly connected to set theory. To be honest, understanding infinity is the main reason why we study set theory. To a mathematician, infinity is beautiful. It is a concept that provides a mathematician a whole amazing world just for the sake of his ideas. Of course, that means that if you're a practically oriented person who wants to see its direct applications in the real world, sorry, you won't meet infinity walking down the street. Still, there is also another reason why set theory is important. It gives a solid framework for mathematics in general. As it turns out, following our intuitions about infinity can easily lead to paradoxes, as when a set is an element of itself, if and only if it is not. Mathematicians had to develop a formal axiomatic framework to deal with these problems, and it turned out that their solution was so universal that it covers virtually any mathematical field. Therefore, set theory actually plays two roles in mathematics. Not only is it the theory of infinity, but it also constitutes the very foundations of mathematics. In the first few videos, we'll start with some intuition for infinity. Then we'll take a look at the paradoxes mentioned before and solve them by introducing a framework in terms of a few axioms. We'll finish with some more advanced tools of set theory, such as the principle of maximality. To begin thinking about infinity, we first have to define it. What do we mean by a rotated number 8? This question is actually too vague for us to answer. We won't even use the infinity symbol in the series. Instead, we'll try to define infinite size. What's infinitely big? Of course, there's a cheap answer. Something infinitely big is something not finitely big. But finitely big is easy to define. A finitely big set is just a set where its numbers of elements can be expressed as a natural number. A set of 5 elements is finite. A set of 100 elements is finite too. But the set of all the natural numbers is too big to be measured by a finite natural number. Therefore, it is infinite in size. Even an empty set is finite. It has 0 elements. That's why we consider 0 as a natural number. This may be somewhat unusual in other fields, but in set theory it turns out to be very natural. According to this definition of infinite sets, in which we defined what infinite isn't, infinity can't be just a large natural number. The whole study of infinity relies on the fact that infinite sets behave in unexpected ways, and this is precisely what our studies are concerned with. Consider the following problem. We have a grid of size 5x5 and we are coloring it using two colors, yellow and blue. If we color it in such a way that all the rows are predominantly blue, some of the columns may happen to be predominantly yellow, but for sure not all of them. Even if we change the remaining columns so that they're predominantly yellow, we will unavoidably break some of the grid's rows. It is an impossible task to carefully choose grid colors in such a configuration in which all the rows are predominantly blue and at the same time all the columns are predominantly yellow. This happens for the simple reason that we cannot fill the table in such a way that there are more blue squares than yellow ones and at the same time there are more yellow squares than blue ones. But what if we pick an infinite grid? In this case, there exists a colorization of the grid such that every row contains only a finite number of yellow squares and every column contains only a finite number of blue ones. I recommend you to pause the video and think about it for a while. You can take your paper and pencil for help. Here comes the solution. Do you see it? Every row is mostly blue and contains only a finite number of yellow squares, and every column is mostly yellow and contains only a finite number of blue squares. The impossible task in the finite world just became possible for the infinite grid. And that is just the beginning. In the next chapter, we will learn how to compare the sizes of infinite sets. See you then!